We have many wonderful photography groups in the Bronx. The Bronx Senior Photo League is teaching photography to Bronx seniors between the ages of 65 and 90. And I'm going to guess that they'll go above 90 if there is somebody above 90. They're not going to cut the, you know. What? You're 90 years old? The ongoing exhibition presents the Bronx through the eyes of these older adults as they explore family, friendship, and community. Joining us to tell more is Rhynna M. Santos, my good buddy, and the Bronx Senior Photo League program coordinator at the Bronx Documentary Center. Nice to have you with us, Rhynna.
Such a pleasure to be here today. Thank you.
Always good. So let's talk about even conceptually now. The Bronx Documentary Center has wonderful photography programs. Talk about the whole notion of a photography program for seniors.
So we wanted to expand from our after-school program called the Bronx Junior Photo League for middle school and high school students.
Which has been highly successful, by the way.
Absolutely. Great. Really being able to teach and foster a lot of wonderful talent, but we wanted to do the same thing with the population that is so completely ignored, which is older adults, 65 through 90
and 90 up. And above, 65
and
up.
That's right.
Are these people who have been photographers in the past, or are they people who say, gee whiz, now I'm 68 years old and I'd like to try it out?
Well, most of our seniors have never held a camera before.
Wow.
And some, you know, taking a few photos with their cell phones here and there, but most of our students have never had any experience. You don't have to have any experience to be in this program. But what's really fantastic about the program is that we're really challenging not just the seniors, but our community in general on how do we look at our older adult population differently.
And I'm waiting for you to finish that sentence. So how do we look at our older adult population differently? And what does this senior photo league teach you and them about either themselves or, you know, a new way to look at who they are?
Well, first of all, besides teaching them how to use a point-and-shoot camera, really what we're trying to foster is self-empowerment and self-esteem. When, you know, we have a very accepted prejudice when it comes to older adults, we would never talk about people from their teens up to their 40s in the same group. But we do that with older adults from 60 to 90 and up and lump everyone into one category when in actuality, each, you know, student, each decade, people are dealing with very unique issues. And the one thing that I have seen through teaching this class is how much incredible work and creativity that my older adult students have, as opposed to this level of accepted prejudice that we have about how at some, after people being able to accomplish so much in their lives, then they hit a certain age and then we think that they can't do anything.
You know, I know that the Junior Photo League that the Documentary Center has run has some very obvious goals. So you give young people a chance to express themselves, to see the world, to go look at, for example, the Bronx River and get a new look at this thing, that body of water from which our borough is named. What are the kinds of things that seniors are getting out of that, and does it have a similar effect on them as people and certainly as they get older?
Well, as our first, you know, mission is to teach documentary photography. But since we're dealing with a population, most of our older adults live, you know, in the poorest congressional district in all of the United States, mm-hmm. dealing with very unique issues like poverty, physical handicap, and otherwise, we really want for them to document their own lives, for them to have a point of view and to add their point of view into the rich tapestry of the history of the Bronx.
What are they interested in taking pictures of? I'm guessing the first thing would be their families or their grandkids or whatever, but tell me a little bit about the output of what they show you.
Well, the class is called Photographing My Life, so they get to document their everyday life. And in reality, what do older adults, what do they do with their day? And you would be surprised. Many older adults are actually continue to work. They're critical caregivers within their family, they're knowledge holders, but they really have, a lot of my students internalize this whole prejudice against older adults, that they can't really do anything. So within this class, we first try to deal with their self-esteem and also the self-esteem of where they're from, which is the Bronx.
You know, the technology in photography has changed so much. I mean, I'm guessing many of them say, what? I don't have to pay for the film or send it out and be developed. How are they adapting to this notion of, you talked about point and shoot. Point and shoot, you can look at the picture right away. I mean, for people who grew up with the older technology, that's an incredible revelation.
Well, we really try to introduce all types of photography, even film photography for them. We also try to use archival photos, like photos that they bring from home that they love. But more importantly, is just really giving them the encouragement to try something new. And also, most importantly, the respect. We really need to respect our older adult population and what they've been able to accomplish through this class.
Do a lot of listening and give them a chance to express themselves. And have you learned anything through it?
Oh, my God. I am in love with this population. I really love teaching. But what I've learned the most is, one, we really, all of us as individuals, have to challenge our own ageism, because our own institutions also reflect the fact that we believe that older adults can't really accomplish much, which is absolutely not true.
Rhynna, I have to ask you about your father, the late Ray Santos.
Yes.
For people who may or may not know, Rhynna is the daughter of one of the Bronx's greatest musicians, and Ray Santos, and he passed recently. And you were his caregiver for a period of time, as I understand.
Yes.
Just talk to me about now looking back at his life, or what you carry with you from the great Ray Santos.
Well, we miss Papi every single minute of every day. Thank you so much for bringing it up. He has been such an incredible person within Latin music, but us, you know, as a family, he's my role model in everything. And I would use him in my class all the time when my seniors...
You still do?
I do, when they feel like I can't really do this. And I'm like, my dad at 90 was using his cell phone and taking photos, but we really want to be able to continue his legacy and to remember, you know, everything that he has done for Latin music.
I hope that people watching the TV can see how Rhynna's face changed when I asked about Papi and I asked about the late Ray Santos. And the memorials that I saw, the tributes I saw, were just glowing. And you, running this senior program, are certainly carrying on the tradition of creativity and art and sharing it with Bronx people that he started. And so thank you so much for doing all of that.
No, thank you very much. And we want to invite everyone for our panel discussion.
Oh, when is that?
This Saturday, December 14th, from 3 to 5 o'clock. We're going to have students, and they're going to talk about their experience being in class and documenting the Bronx.
Listen, you're just doing great work. Rhynna M. Santos, thank you so much
thank
for
you.
Joining us on Open. The Bronx Senior Photo League is holding a panel discussion that she mentioned. It's taking place Saturday the 14th. From 3 to 5 p.m., you can see a sample of it on your screen now. Exhibition is open until February 2nd, 2020. That sounds crazy. At the Bronx Documentary Center. If you don't know where the Bronx Documentary Center is, you gotta get over there. 614 Cortland Avenue, one of the absolute great places in the Bronx. You can visit their website at bronxdoc.org. You can visit them on Instagram at Bronx Senior Photo League. And thank you again, and thank you all the guests. We've come to the end of the show today. My goodness. We'd like to thank all our guests for joining us. Thank you for tuning in. If you missed any part of today's show, you can catch the recast at 5 and 10 p.m. on Optimum Channel 67, Verizon Fios 33, or watch anytime on the web. Of course, everything is automatic at bronxnet.org. You can catch a brand new episode of Open with my buddy Rhynna Valentin on Friday. And that's it. That wraps it up. Wraps it up for us here on Open. I'm Gary Axelbank. Darren should be back with you next week. And make sure to keep this channel on BronxNet wide open. We'll see you soon. Happy holidays.